कैसे इन कंप्यूटर. सो इन कंप्यूटिंग कैसे इज अ हार्डवेयर और सॉफ्टवेयर कंपोनेंट दैट स्टोर्स डेटा सो दैट द फ्यूचर रिक्वेस्ट फॉर द डेटा कैन बी सर्व्ड फास्टर. द डेटा स्टोर्ड इन ए कैसे माइट बी द रिजल्ट ऑफ अर्लियर कंप्यूटेशन और ए कॉपी ऑफ डेटा स्टोर्ड एल्सवेयर. नाउ देयर आर टू डिफरेंट टर्म्स दैट वी टिपिकली यूज इन टर्म्स ऑफ कैसे कैसे हिट एंड कैसे मिस. कैसे हिट अकर्स व्हेन द रिक्वेस्टेड डेटा कैन बी फाउंड इन द कैसे एंड इफ द रिक्वेस्टेड डेटा कैन नॉट बी फाउंड इन कैसे देन वी कॉल दैट कैसे मिस. नाउ लेट्स ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड मोर अबाउट कैसे. एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी टॉक्ड दैट कैसिंग इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ स्टोरिंग कॉपीज ऑफ फाइल्स इन अ कैसे और टेम्पररी स्टोरेज लोकेशन सो दैट दे कैन बी एक्सेस्ड मोर क्विकली. सो द बेनिफिट ऑफ इट इज वी कैन गेट द डेटा और फाइल क्विकली. टेक्निकली एक ऐसे इज एनी टेम्पररी स्टोरेज लोकेशन फॉर कॉपीज ऑफ फाइल्स और डेटा बट द टर्म इज ऑफन यूज इन रेफरेंस टू द इंटरनेट टेक्नोलॉजीज. वेब ब्राउजर ऑल्सो कैसेज सच एज एचटीएमएल फाइल्स जावास्क्रिप्ट्स इमेजेस एटसेट्रा. एज इज सेड ब्राउजर ऑल्सो डू कैसिंग. सो वॉट डज द ब्राउजर कैसे डू. एवरी टाइम ए यूजर लोड्स अ वेब पेज देयर ब्राउजर हैज टू डाउनलोड क्वाइट अ लॉट ऑफ डेटा इन ऑर्डर टू डिस्प्ले द वेब पेज and that is going to take lot of time every time user will refresh it. So to shorten or to ease the time, to limit the time, to reduce the time, browser cache most of the content that appears on the web page, saving a copy of the web page content on the device hard drive. In this way the next time the user loads the page, most of the content is already stored locally and the page will load much more quickly. Now we can clear the cache as well if we want the latest thing to appear every time, to load every time, then we can definitely clear the cache from the browser. Now one of the thing that most of us know, CDN, content delivery network, it also does the caching. It caches the content such as images or static files on the server so that user don't need to visit the main server, but instead the proxy server can return the cached content from the CDN. CDN caching servers are located in data centers all over the globe. Cloudflare has CDN servers in 200 cities spread out throughout the world in order to be as close to the end user. A location where CDN servers are present is also called the data centers. There is a very good article on AWS about cache. A cache is a high-speed data storage layer which stores a subset of data, typically a transient in nature, so that future requests for the data are served up faster than is possibly by accessing the data primary storage location. Caching allows you to efficiently reuse previously retrieved or computed data. Now let's understand how does caching work. The data in a cache is generally stored in fast access hardware such as RAM and may also be used in correlation with a software component. A cache primary purpose is to increase data retrieval performance by reducing the need to access the underlying slow storage layer. So trading off capacity for speed, a cache typically stores a subset of data transiently, in contrast to database whose data is usually complete and durable. In this diagram, we can see how the cache will work. Every time a user accesses the content on mobile or desktop via internet, some of the web content stored in cache, so the application don't need to visit the actual servers, let it be application server or let it be the database servers. From cache itself, user can see the data. The cache content can be returned to the data, can be returned to the end user. Browser and memory caching. Memory cache stores data locally on the computer that are on the application or browser runs on. When a browser is active, the resources it retrieves are stored in its random access memory or the hard drive. The next time the resources are needed to be loaded on web page, the browser pulls them from the cache rather than from the remote server, which reduces the time and which makes it quicker to retrieve resources and load the pages. When we compare it with CDN, caching is one job of CDN which stores the data in geographically distributed location to reduce the load time, handle vast amount of traffic and protect against cyber attacks. Now in web, there are two kinds of caching: web client caching and web server caching. So web client caching, cached content are stored on the client itself. And in web server caching, it is a mechanism that aimed at storing resources server side for reuse. Specifically, such an approach is helpful when dealing with dynamically generated content which takes time to be created. We already talked on CDN caching. Now in this diagram you can see when there is no caching, every user request goes to the remote server directly, which takes more time compared to when we will have the caching implementation. Only the first time user data is served from the remote server, but the subsequent request will be received from the cache. Cache stores then all the data which is accessed frequently by the same user over the other users. The web cache flow works as: browser sends an HTTP request to the web cache. Cache request responds. If the requested resource is stored in cache, the cache responds with the requested resource. If the requested resource is not in cache, the web cache requests the object from the server and sends a response back to the browser. If the resource from the response is cacheable, the web cache permits the copy of the resource so that the subsequent request is served locally from the cache. Now, what are the pros of it? First of all, it improves the response time. Second, it gives low network uses. And third, continuous availability of data, which means in the case of network interruption, caching can be used to serve the content to the end user even when the server is unavailable for a short period of time. Now, what are the content that we can cache? We can cache media files, logo, images, any static files, CSS, JavaScript files, etc. So today we talked about caching and how caching works. So thank you viewers, and if you think the video is helpful, please like the video and subscribe the channel. Thank you for watching the Software Circle channel.